Hi, this is Csaba Ortutai from Bioinformatics Academy. This video demonstration is a part of our phylogenetics web course. Here, I will introduce you some of the most important terminology related to phylogenetic trees. I will demonstrate now concepts and terms using a tree visualization software called Archaeopteryx, a free Java program available for anybody who is dealing with phylogenetic data. Trees are special representation of evolutionary data and the natural history of genes, proteins, or species. These trees are coming from graph theory, therefore the basic terminology comes from there too. We are talking about nodes and connecting edges. Nodes are sometimes referred as vertices and edges as branches. We distinguish terminal nodes representing the actual sequences, genes, or species, and internal nodes representing hypothetical common ancestors. Additionally, on most of the phylogenetic trees which are in use, there is a special internal node called the root of the tree. It represents the common ancestor of all the species or sequences represented by the tree. Traditionally, we interpret these trees so that time flows from the root towards the terminal nodes, sometimes also referred as the leaves. Branches connect nodes either internal or terminal ones. A path is a series of edges connecting two nodes, usually two terminal leaves of the tree. Internal nodes representing the ancestors of descendants, where evolution and selection produce two different offsprings, therefore where an incoming branch split it to two descendant branches. In optimal cases, all the internal nodes of a phylogenetic tree have exactly one incoming and two outgoing branches. These trees are fully dichotomous or bifurcating ones. Sometimes it's not possible to figure out the exact order of the internal nodes, or some of them are too close in time to each other to be possible to be resolved. In such cases, some internal nodes have three or more descendant branches. These nodes are called multitomies, and such a tree is multifurcating tree. Some methods, including bootstrapping and Bayesian approaches, can produce different supporting values for internal nodes. Usually these supporting values can be interpreted as how reliable that internal nodes are. These bootstrap values or Bayesian posteriors are shown next to each internal node. The exact order of the internal nodes and how they are connected to terminal leaves is the topology of the tree. The determination of the tree topology is the first and most immediate goal of a phylogenetic analysis. We have to be very careful, because branches of a tree can be swept around at any internal nodes. Swapping doesn't alter the topology of the tree, but it can create suggestive visualization of the same tree. For example, this is a tree of selected vertebrate species coming from an analysis of certain protein sequences. You can see bats and birds here on this tree. If I'm studying the origin of flying lifestyle, I can swap the branches so that flying animals are next to each other. This can be misleading and prone to false conclusions. We might think that because flying mammals and birds are next to each other on this tree, they had a flying capable common ancestor, which is obviously not true. Finally, I want to show you the difference between rooted and unrooted trees. Most of the phylogenetic algorithms produce unrooted trees. We have to make further steps to place the root of the tree and transform the results to a rooted tree. The most useful approach for that is the outgroup method, when a closely related group of species and sequences are included to the original analysis. These are known to branch out first from the rest of the analysis subjects, therefore we can place the root of the tree between the outgroup and the real subject of the analysis, as you can see here. Thank you for watching this brief tutorial about the important terms used in phylogenetics. Please see our web course for the detailed explanations and for further methods and practices used in phylogenetics.